All right, this is Ace with Rock Revolt Magazine. I'm here with Lindy Gabriel of Gabriel and the Apocalypse. How are you doing this morning?
I'm well. How are you?
I'm good. This is kind of bright and early for somebody out on tour, isn't it?
Yes, it is. But, you know, we were finally able to, like, sleep. This is, like, sleeping in to us, like, today, actually. But we actually got a hotel. We're not sleeping in the van. So I feel pretty well rested right now. It feels good.
Right on. Well, how is Texas treating you guys? Did Austin last night, getting ready to play Houston today? How's Texas treating you guys?
Well, I mean, it's been so much fun, and the crowds have just been just really eating it up. And, I mean, we're having such a good time out here. And we only have, like, I don't know, 5 or 6 dates left. So it's kind of sad. Like, we're just kind of getting into the grind of everything and, you know, becoming friends with other bands and stuff. So, but, no, it's been great.
Right. You guys will be closing it at home in Minneapolis with the beginning of November, right?
Yes, November 5th.
What is it with the Minneapolis music scene? I mean, I love that music scene up there. So many great bands have come out of Minneapolis and lately and even, you know, years back. What do you think attributes to that, you being a part of that?
You know, a lot of people ask me that. I mean, I just think that there's a lot of support out there with, you know, radio or just people coming up to the shows and supporting the artists. And there's just, like, in general, a wide range of just art and culture out there and like, a community. So, and I think that's a big part of it.
Right. And I'm glad you brought up support, because I have seen you several times in Des Moines supporting another Minneapolis band, American Head Charge, when I come up from Kansas City to go to their shows. So you are out there supporting all the time. I've seen you many a times in Des Moines. Yeah, no, that's another great band out there. I'm actually wearing my American Head Charge shirt today, so.
I love American Head Charge. I mean, they've inspired us, you know, just like, you know, the kind of old school Head Charge, like that, the army, you know, the chaos that they just bring to the stage. You know, I think we've really been inspired by that.
Right on. Well, that's awesome. Like I said, it's great that you're out there supporting, even if it's in another city, in another state. You guys are right now touring in support of the Ghost Parade. Just came out a little over a week ago. How's that doing for you guys right now?
Doing well. I haven't heard one bad review yet. I'm waiting for it, but I mean, it's been really well received. Like, I've been getting a lot of emails and just, you know, people reaching out to us just saying how they love the record, or how, you know, they want to listen to more music like that. And so, I mean, that's just wonderful that people are seeming to really enjoy it.
Right. And this will be your third release, your first one on Pavement Entertainment. What's the difference with releasing those two independents and actually having a label backing you up this time? It's got to be a breath of fresh air, yeah?
Oh, my God, it is. I mean, we've been a band for a while. We've always done everything completely independently, you know, and having a label step in and kind of have our back and help us with other things that necessarily we couldn't really do, you know, independently, or be a lot, you know, more difficult, I guess, to do that. So it's, you know, we definitely have a team now behind us, and it just, I mean, it feels great. I just, Pavement's been wonderful, and I can't wait to see what the future brings with them.
Right, I was saying, I mean, you know, personally, you working so hard on those first two independent albums, you and the band, and then just finally getting that backup. Personally, you know, being the, you know, the face of the band, it's just got to make you feel great that the hard work does pay off.
You know, yeah, I mean, and it's crazy because the label came and gave us an offer at a time where I was almost going to be done with music. It was just weird how the universe works. Like, I was going to be done, and then we get a, you know, a record deal offer. I'm like, what? Are you serious? Like, you know what I mean? So, but I'm so glad, you know, we gave it a shot, and things have been great, you know. But it's just something that we've worked toward for a really long time, and it does feel great to just to enjoy some things now.
If you don't mind me asking, I mean, why were you ready to hang it up?
Well, I mean, I think, you know, the music business is like, it is a roller coaster. I mean, there's a lot of sacrifice, a lot of hard work in it, and I think we've just been pounding at that for years and years, you know. And at the time, you know, we had like a bad management, and things were just like they're becoming like not fun anymore, you know. It was just like, and Figgles, my keyboard player, who's been in the band for 8 years, like he's like my partner in crime, my right hand man, you know. And you know, he decided to leave, and I was just like, I've always said, if I can't, I do not want to play in a band without you, like you're my guy, you know. And but then we got the record deal offer, you know, and then we decided to just kind of put things back together and build a new band. You know, we have 3 new band members, and Figgles came back, and we had the wonderful Pavement family behind us, and I'm glad we just put everything back together and, you know, got the negative energy out of the circle of Gear in the Apocalypse, and things have been the best they've ever been, and the lineup is just stronger than ever.
So did you have this album written before or after you were kind of, you know, on the fence?
There's about half of the record was written before Pavement, and then the other half was written after we got, you know, that we signed the record deal. And the opening track, March of the Dolls, is basically the idea of, you know, I put it back together, what matters is the ending, you know. The lyrics are just like kind of coming back when you thought I was gone, you know. I'm just kind of coming back in full force.
Right, and you guys did label this thing as like it's a concept album for you. Talks about a lot of the things that you guys have always stuck on, politics, issues, stuff like that. But you dug in a little more personal on this one, right?
I did, definitely. And that's something that I've always kind of tried to avoid, you know. But this one, I was very honest. And, you know, with the concept of it, I mean, half of it is, you know, the political side, and or like, you know, about society, you know, becoming ghost, you know, metaphorically, and, you know, being distracted with things that don't matter when this, you know, world is falling apart and we need to unite and address those issues. But the other half of it is, on a personal note, is watching someone that you care about or love that you're with becoming a ghost through drug use, you know, drug addiction. And that was a part of my life that was just, like, really hard for me to understand, because I've never been, you know, like into drugs or anything, and to like be introduced into that world, and it was just pretty shocking. And trying to, you know, save somebody, and then coming to the painful realization, like I can't do anything about it, and so I just wrote about it, and basically about, you know, watching someone become a ghost in front of your eyes, you know. And so yeah, so that's like the personal part that I wrote about it too. So,
do you think that maybe having that kind of mindset that you were, you know, kind of like, the hell with it, I'm done, allowed you to open up more personally, because you were just letting things go because you really were kind of done with it?
Yeah, I mean, that could totally be it, you know. Just like not wanting to hide anymore, or just like being completely open and honest, and not minding how people, you know, may judge me, or, you know. So, yeah, I can definitely see that.
Right on. And I've talked to a lot of bands out of Minneapolis. Like I said, it's a great venue, great city, great music. A lot of them have had some great road stories. What are you guys doing on the road to keep your mind right and not go crazy? You guys having any shenanigans, anything going on out there?
Oh, man. Well, I guess Gabriel of Apocalypse and Wednesday 13 both got parking tickets together, so that was pretty cool, you know, like that, you know. man, you know, we kind of, I don't know, man, it's like it's a party every night. I mean, we're definitely business first, right, you know, but we definitely, people kind of gravitate toward us because we're kind of like the let's have a good old time and anything goes kind of band, you know. I don't know. We've had a lot. I mean, it's hard to like just like pick, you know, a certain, because like every day is just kind of like a circus, really.
a new adventure every day. Nothing boring.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
Well, what are you doing to stay busy between stops on the road? I mean, are you writing more? Are you just hanging out, relaxing? What are you doing to stay busy?
Well, I started reading Nikki Sixx's book, This Is Gonna Hurt. I started reading that. And been kind of like writing like little doodles and such. And I wanted to keep a journal the whole time, but that just like, well, I guess wasn't realistic, but I brought one with. But and just trying to, you know, get some rest in as much as I can. There's been a lot of driving on this tour, so yeah, there's not much downtime. You know, like on previous tours, like we did with Head Charge, we had a lot more downtime. We don't really have that really on this tour. But, yeah, I guess just, you know, we had a hotel the other day, and I'm, like, resting, and, like, everyone else is, like, partying, hanging out, you know, with people in the hot tub and whooping it up. But I'm like, okay, I need a rest. I need to recharge. So I'm kind of more the mellower one when we have, like, downtime, I guess. So.
Ain't nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that at all. So when you guys wrap this tour up in November, I mean, what's next? You guys going to plan another tour? Are we going to see you guys a little bit more? Because I know you guys kind of hit, like, the, you know, West Coast and coming around, finishing down south and then heading north. But still a lot of cities need to see you guys.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, what we're going to do is after the hometown CD release bash, we are going to shoot a new music video, and we'll release it, you know, probably February, March. And we hope to go on tour again in February, March as well. We don't have anything completely set up yet, but we've been kind of working on it and networking with that. So that's the plan. You know, we want to keep the momentum going and, you know, give it an honest shot. So we definitely want to be touring the most we've ever toured in 2017.
Absolutely. Well, Lindy, tell everybody where they can get the Ghost Parade and how to get a hold of you guys.
You got it. You can get the Ghost Parade pretty much anywhere, Amazon, iTunes, Spotify. That's pretty much, you can get it anywhere. You can get it at a live show, physical copy. Reach out to us, GabrielApocalypse.com, our Facebook. We have Twitter. So, yeah, you can find it. You can search for it. I mean, it'll pop up. You'll get it.
Absolutely. Well, I'm going to let you get back to enjoying your day since you got a little time off before you guys get to hit the stage again tonight. So I greatly appreciate your time. And if there's ever anything we can do for you, just let us know, okay?
Thank you. I so appreciate it. And it was nice talking to you. And make sure you keep in touch.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Good luck out there.
Thank you.
Thanks, Lindy. Bye-bye.